We want to close and wrap it up with this. Tell us, there are thousands upon thousands watching us, and there are many sincere people out there, our brothers in humanity, that are listening, and they hear this clear message that you're explaining to them. It makes sense. It's rational. It's not something where you have to do a lot of mental gymnastics to make fit. And you know what? They want to get to paradise. They want to do what the Creator wants them to do. Give them some advice on how they can come over and do and live that life of all the messengers of God, worshiping God alone, and at the end, being in paradise and being our brothers in faith. Can you give them some advice?
The advice that I give to the non-Muslim brothers is that agree at least one scripture is the word of God. So Christian would not mind saying that, okay, what the Bible says is the word of God. The Hindu would not mind saying that Veda is the word of God. The Muslim would not mind saying that the Quran is the word of God. So I tell them, what is common in all these scriptures? Let us agree to follow that. What is difference? What is differing? We can discuss tomorrow. Let us agree to follow 100% what is common in all these scriptures. And when you do research, you come to know all the scriptures say there is one God. All the quotations I gave from the Bible, yes. I can give from the Vedas, same in the Quran. All the scriptures say that God has got no images. He has got no idols. God does not beget. He has got no children. He has got no father. All the scriptures say that the last and final messenger is Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him. Bible says in several places, in the book of Deuteronomy chapter number 18, verse number 18, in the book of Deuteronomy chapter number 18, verse number 19, in the book of Isaiah chapter 29, verse number 12, in the Song of Solomon chapter 5, verse number 16, in the Gospel of John chapter 14, verse 16, in the Gospel of John chapter 15, verse 26, in the Gospel of John chapter 16, verse number 7, in the Gospel of John chapter 16, verse number 11 to 14. I can go on and on, only quoting references. You can give a talk for hours together. Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam in the Bible. You can give a talk for us together, Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam in the Hindu scriptures. So when it is clearly mentioned in all the scriptures, God is one who has got no images, who has got no idols. He is not a human being. He has got no father. He has got no son. All the scriptures say the last and final messenger to come is Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Not only in the Christian scriptures or the Hindu scriptures, in the Parsi scriptures, in the Buddhist scriptures, all these scriptures. So I request all the brothers from throughout the world, read your scriptures. At least agree to follow what is common. And then you'll come to know, and you'll have to believe, if you're sincere, that there is no God but Allah, and Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, is the messenger of Almighty.